Let's now bring in former State Department spokesperson Morgan Ortagus. Great to see you, Morgan. What did you make of the Summit for Democracy?
Well, you just said everything that I wanted to say in the last 7 minutes, so that was a fantastic monologue. I'm sort of struggling. I thought, God, Steve's hitting all the best points. Listen, let me start out by saying, and you might laugh at me or make fun of me for this, I don't dislike the idea of a summit for democracies. I actually think getting countries together that are going to be allied with us over our generation's struggle, Steve, for the fight against the Chinese Communist Party and their ambition to dominate the planet. I think that's incredibly important. And in fact, when they initially invited Taiwan, for example, I thought, okay, this is a good move. Maybe this is going to have teeth. But the problem with having a summit of democracies and not having any action, not having anything to back it up, is that it ends up just being a summit of words, right? And so what the world needs to see, how do we ensure that the rules-based order that we all live, that we have enjoyed since World War II, how do we make sure that we're still a global superpower and that we don't literally have the communist running our international organizations and institutions? We ensure that by having a strong economy, by having a people and a strong border, by having a strong military, by having deterrence, and a strong military. So I think that, again, my issue is not having is not the fact that they had a summit. I think that they had a summit is great. My problem is that if you don't have teeth behind your words, then they are empty and hollow and meaningless words.
Exactly right, and that's the massive contrast, of course, with this Biden regime and what in the one you were part of. You know, where you actually had the substance to back up the policy positions that were articulated with words. There's one specific thing you brought to our attention. Actually, you mentioned Taiwan and China, and they invited Taiwan, but then did something really extraordinary to undermine the whole point of bringing Taiwan to the summit.
Yeah, that's right. So as you mentioned, they invited Taiwan, which, you know, formally our policy in the U.S. under many administrations, including President Trump that I served in, is, you know, it's sort of the best way to describe it is a policy of ambiguity. We want the issue of Taiwan and their sovereignty to be solved peacefully and not to have China militarily overtake them. Right. So by inviting them to the summit, it was somewhat provocative and I think a very good move. The problem is when one of the Taiwanese government representatives was speaking, they apparently, Reuters is reporting this, Humaira Padmuk from Reuters is reporting, that they had a map up that showed a color, the color of Taiwan being different from China. And so the American government did something that happens in China all the time. But this was the American government that did it. What did they do, Steve? They cut the feed. They cut the video feed of the Taiwanese representative speaking because, I guess, that they were worried that the Chinese were going to be offended that Taiwan was in a different color than China on the map. It sounds weird, and it is weird. It sounds strange. But this is, why is this important? Because this is the kind of stuff that the Chinese Communist Party does. They censor speech that they don't want to hear, right? They cut off the video feed of, well, they would probably never let Fox in China, but even like CNBC or CNN, other stations, if they hear something that they don't want to hear, they'll just cut the feed, right, of the American news organizations. We saw many reporters from major publications like the New York Times and the Washington Post, while I was State Department spokesperson, they just kicked the reporters out of the country, and for other or did not renew their visas. And for other countries like Australia and other countries that aren't as strong as ours, I was going to say lesser powers, but we're all equal in this fight against the Chinese Communist Party.
Very diplomatic of
they
you.
Would harass them, jail them. No, I'm trying. So listen, I think this matters because this isn't hyperbole. This isn't me being dramatic, Steve. But when I say that the communists that rule China want to rule the world order, they want to have the institutions in their favor, that's why we have to care, right? I'm not being an interventionalist. I'm not calling for any action, but I'm saying the Chinese Communist Party represents strength. And when you have the Americans cutting the feet of the Taiwanese because they don't like the picture of the map, that's, you know, that type of censoring is what goes on in China, not in America.
Exactly. Well put. And in fact, I've got a few things to say about that specific issue of China a bit later on and how corporate America is responding. So it's a nice compliment to what you said there about the Biden regime. Great to see you, Morgan. Thank you.
Hey, Sean Hannity here. Hey, click here to subscribe to Fox News YouTube page and catch our hottest interviews and most compelling analysis. You will not get it anywhere else.